Class 7 SOF NSO, today we'll see Chapter 11 Light. Question number 1. Which of the following is true regarding convex lens? When an object is within the focal length, the convex lens produces virtual, erect and magnified image used in magnifying lenses. And when the object is in between F and 2F, the convex lens produces real, inverted and magnified image used in projectors and cameras. Question number 2. If an object is kept at a distance of 15 cm in front of a mirror as shown in the given figure, then the distance between its image and the mirror will be? An image of the object is formed when light rays coming from the object meet or appear to meet at a point after reflection from a mirror. Properties of image formed by a plane mirror are: the image is virtual and erect. The distance of the image from mirror is equal to the distance of an object from mirror. The size of the image is exactly equal to the distance of object from mirror. The image is laterally inverted. So according to this, the distance of image from mirror is equal to the distance of object from mirror. Our answer will be 15 centimeters. Question number 3. Two plane mirrors are inclined at an angle of 75 degrees as shown in the given figure. If angle R is equal to 35 degrees, then angle X will be equal to. We are given that the plane mirrors are inclined at an angle of 75 degrees. If angle R is equal to 35 degrees, then the angle of incidence, that is angle S, is equal to 55 degrees, which is also equal to angle T, the angle of reflection. Now, since angle R plus angle S plus angle T plus angle U lie on a straight line, their sum is 180 degrees. So, angle U is equal to 35 degrees. Next, angle U and angle Y. And the angle between the two mirrors is 75 degrees, form a triangle. Since we know that the sum of interior angles of a triangle are 180, we can find the value of angle Y, that is 70 degrees. At the second mirror, the ray makes angle Y is equal to 70 degrees with the mirror surface. So, with the normal, the angle is equal to 20 degrees, that is the angle of incidence. By the law of reflection, angle of incidence is equal to 20 degrees, which is equal to angle of reflection, which is equal to X. So, the angle of reflection, that is X, is equal to 20 degrees. Question number 4. David is observing his image in a plane mirror. The distance between the mirror and his image is 4 meters. If he moves 2 meters towards the mirror, then the distance between David and his image will be. David is standing in front of a mirror. The distance between the mirror and his image is 4 meters. If David walks 2 meters towards the mirror, then the distance between David and his image becomes 4 meters, because the distance of the image from the mirror is always equal to the distance of the object from the mirror. Question number 5. Which of the following statements regarding a rainbow is correct? White sunlight is actually a mix of 7 colors. Each color bends by a different amount when it enters and leaves the raindrop. Since violet bends more, it comes out at a lower angle, so we see it at the bottom. Red bends less, so it comes out in a higher angle, so we see it at the top. Question number 6. An object shown in the figure is held in front of a plane mirror. Which of the following images will be formed for the given image? The image formed by a plane mirror is always virtual, erect, of the same size as the object, laterally inverted, left and right are swapped, and at the same distance behind the mirror as the object in front. So according to this, our correct option is the B option. Question number 7. A man looked into a plane mirror on a wall. He saw the image of a clock behind him as shown below. The time shown by the clock was? A mirror's reflection on a mirror image is the representation of an item in the mirror. The right side of the item appears to the left side in such a picture, and vice versa. As a result, the term lateral inversion is used to describe this phenomena of a mirror image that has been laterally inverted. For each clock-based mirror image, if the clock has 12 hours, take the specified time and subtract it from 1160 hours. The given clock shows 1150. To find the actual time, we subtract 1150 from 1160, which gives 010, that is 1210. In addition, if the clock is 24 hours, subtract the supplied time from 2060. Question number 8. The refractive index of four materials P, Q, R and S are 1.33, 1.43, 1.71 and 1.52 respectively. When the light rays pass from air into these materials, they refract the maximum in their material. The refractive index of a medium is basically its light bending power, showing how much light shows down and changes direction when passing through it. The refraction of a light rays will be maximum in the substances having highest refractive index. Now, out of P, Q, R and S, R has the highest refractive index. So, the refraction of the light will be maximum in material R. Question number 9. A person standing in front of a mirror finds his image larger than himself. This implies that the mirror is. A plane mirror always forms a virtual erect image of the same size. A convex mirror forms a virtual, erect and a diminished image, while a concave mirror can form either a real, an inverted image or a virtual and magnified image depending on the object's position. When an object is kept between pole and focus of a concave mirror, the image is virtual, erect and magnified. Therefore, the mirror is a concave mirror. Question number 10. Two men are standing in front of a mirror as shown. If man P walks 5 meters backwards and then looks into the mirror, how far away from him will man Q seem to be? Let us calculate the distance between man P and the image of man Q. If we calculate, we'll get 21 meters. Question number 11. Two parallel rays of light strike a concave mirror. Which of the following correctly shows the path of the rays after striking the mirror? If we see in the A and C option, they have given a convex mirror. Here we only need a concave mirror. So we can exclude the option A and C. A concave mirror bends the light rays inward and makes them meet at a point. That's why it's called a converging mirror. As we can see here, in the B option, we can see that the rays meet at a point. That is converging. But in the D, they don't meet at a point. Question number 12. In a mirror image of the word electric, which alphabets appear the same? The alphabets T and I appear the same. Question 13. Which of the following statements is or are true regarding the effects of using a thin converging lens instead of the thick converging lens? First one, the image formed will be brighter. A thick lens absorbs more light, so the image appears dimmer, whereas a thinner light lets more light through, resulting in a brighter image. Second one, the focal length will be longer. Using a thin converging lens instead of a thick converging lens results in a longer focal length, meaning light rays converge at a greater distance from the lens. Third one, the image formed will always be virtual. A convex lens forms a real and inverted image. So the third option is wrong. So the correct option is 1 and 2 only. Question number 14. Image of the teeth seen by a dentist while testing the teeth is. Dentists use a concave mirror while checking teeth. When the teeth are within the focal length of the concave mirror, the image formed is virtual, erect and magnified. Question number 15. An object O is placed in front of a plane mirror MN as shown in the given diagram. A student moves her eye along the line XY to observe the image of O. Identify the point on the line XY where the image of O can be seen. The lines MP and NQ represent the limiting rays of vision range from where the image can be seen. The image of O can be seen within this range. Since point 4 lies outside this range, the student cannot see the image of O from there. Let us look at lens versus mirrors. Achiever section question number 16. Match column 1 with column 2 and select the correct option from the given codes. Street lights use convex mirrors to diverge light over an extended area. Concave mirrors are used as a reflector in search lights, torches to get powerful parallel beam of light. Thicker in the middle will be convex lens. Rainbow will be dispersion and thinner in the middle will be concave lens. Achiever section question number 17. Read the following statements and select the correct option. Statement 1. If an object is placed at a distance of 5 cm from a plane mirror, then the distance between the image and the mirror is 5 cm. Which is true. The image formed by a plane mirror is as far behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. Yes, this is also true. And yes, statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. Achiever section question number 18. A mirror is tilted at an angle of 30 degrees to the bench. A ray of light is directed so that it hits the mirror at an angle of 40 degrees to the surface of the mirror. What is the angle of reflection? Angle between mirror surface and normal is 90 degrees. Given, angle between the incident ray and the mirror is 40 degrees. Therefore, angle between the incident ray and the normal ray is equal to 50 degrees. By the law of reflection, angle of reflection R, which is equal to I, which is equal to 50 degrees. Achiever section question number 19. Anu focused a torchlight at a bunch of grapes as shown in the given figure. What can Anu do to enlarge the shadow of a bunch of grapes on the screen? First one, she can shift the grapes nearer to the torches. Yes, this is true. If you shift the grapes nearer to the torch, the image will be enlarged. Shift the screen away from the grapes. Yes, this is also true. Shift the screen closer to the grapes. Wrong. If you shift the screen closer, you will get a smaller image, not an enlarged image. Shift the torch further away from the grapes. This is also false. So the correct option is 1 and 2. Achiever section question number 20. A bus driver is reversing his bus at a speed of 8 meter per second. The rear view mirror of the bus is a plane mirror. The driver sees in his rear view mirror the image of a car parked behind his bus. The speed at which the image of the car appears to approach the driver will be. A bus driver is reversing his bus at a speed of 8 meter per second. The image of the parked car in rear view mirror seems to move with the speed in forward direction as 8 meters per second. Therefore, the net speed at which the image of the car appears to the driver is 8 minus of minus 8 is equal to 16 meter per second. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload.